Welcome back to Your Travel with Olivia. I'm Olivia, and this is the channel where you're going to come to for news and advice on traveling smart, safe, and with a plan. How do you prevent ear pain during a flight landing? Well, that's what I want to go over today. Many of you know that I was a nurse before, or I'm still a nurse, I guess. Once a nurse, always a nurse. And this is Nurses Week, and while we're on that subject, I just want to give a huge shout out to all of the nurses out there for your dedication and the care that you bring the community each and every day, 24/7. As a nurse, I used to work in a travel clinic, and so I used to get a lot of clients who came in and talked about the excruciating pain that they used to feel when they were traveling, especially when the plane was descending. The pain used to be so unbearable. So I used to give them some tips on some of the ways that they could actually reduce the pain in their ear. I know because I used to feel it myself until I got these earplugs, and I've used them every single time I am in a plane and I am landing. I put these earplugs in order to decrease the pressure. One of the things that you can do is drink a lot, not alcohol, but fluids. One of the things that this does is helps to keep the eustachian tubes, which is your ear canal. It keeps it open, as well as it will help to reduce the mucus buildup in the eardrum, reducing the amount of pressure that you could feel. Second, chew gum. Same idea, is actually just keeping that the mobility of the ear canal moving at all times. This will also help to reduce that pressure that's there, as well as at the same time, you'll end up swallowing more. Another exercise to keep the pressure as equalized as possible. Another thing that you can do is yawning. Actually, by yawning, you are opening up the ear canals again and again, helping to keep the air moving and the airflow, as well as the fluid that gets built up in there as well, which is one of the reasons that the pressure is so intense. You've got air pressing on the eardrum, you've got fluid that's sitting there behind, and it's pushing on the eardrum itself, which is causing that excruciating pain. So that the more that you can do to open that up and to keep it mobile will help to reduce the chances of that air and fluid buildup in your ears. But everybody is different, so it depends on whenever you feel it. But if on ascension or descension of the plane, that's probably the best time to make sure that you do these practices. Also, another suggestion would be to take a decongestant probably about 30 minutes before your flight. This will also help to keep the ear tubes clear and open them up as well. Another suggestion that I have for people who are prone to wax buildup, and therefore it causes a bit of an issue when they are traveling, is to get your ears flushed before you travel. You can go to your doctor, but if you're unable to make it to the doctor or you don't have access to one, here's another quick little suggestion for you. Equal parts of a couple drops of mineral oil and a couple drops of hydrogen peroxide, mix those together. The bubbly action of the hydrogen peroxide will help to stimulate and move the earwax around, and the mineral oil will help to soften it. A couple drops of those in both ears, leave it in for a minimum of half an hour. Same idea, overnight is the best possible practice you can do. Hopefully that helps to keep your ears clean and clear. And the final thing, of course, is to stay awake when the plane is descending. And that's why about 15-20 minutes before the plane is descending, you'll hear the pilot come on to let you know that he's going to be descending the plane. This is to help wake people up so that they can prepare themselves. If it's chewing gum, drinking, getting those earplugs in, whatever it takes for you to help hopefully decrease your chances of discomfort. And that is why he comes on and announces at that time. What about the children? Depending on their age category, how much can you rely on the kids to look after themselves? If they're older, you can let them know about the drinking, the chewing gum, etc. You can give them a decongestion. You can actually give them a bit of Tylenol before their flight as well to decrease the pain. But little kids, their ear tubes are more narrow and smaller than the adults. And so they are more predisposed to that painful discomfort that you'll get when the plane is ascending or descending. So pay attention to your child. If you have an infant, maybe this is a good time to give them a bottle or to nurse, offer them their pacifier, whatever it takes to help reduce that pain, because chances are that piercing scream that they're having right there is because that pressure is building up in their ears, and it is a very painful experience for them. So help them out, help out the kids, help out yourself, look after your ears when you are in flight, when you are descending, and hopefully you have a much more pleasant flight the next time that you are flying. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hey, I hope that you got a lot of value and information out of today's video. If you did, don't forget to share that with your friends and family and peers out there. Also, don't forget, if you have any suggestions of any ways that you have dealt with the ear pain that you may have experienced yourself, or you have heard others have suggested, please go ahead and put that in the comments section down below. As well as if you have any questions, that's what I'm here for, is to answer all of your questions or any of your concerns. Thank you again to all my subscribers out there for staying tuned to this channel. But if this is your first time visiting this channel, please consider subscribing by hitting the subscribe button down below, as well as hitting the bell, which is beside the subscribe button. This will notify you that I've just uploaded a new video, because I'm here every single week bringing you different topics on anything to do with travel. Again, if you do have any suggestions as to what you would like to hear me talk about, please also add that in the comments section down below. I look forward to seeing you again next week. But if this is your week to travel, I would love to wish you a safe trip there as well as a safe return home. Thank you so much again, and adios.